Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Pat Summit Show. This week, the Lady Vols ended a two-game swing in the state of Mississippi with a 10-point win over Ole Miss, 66-56, and then returned home in front of over 13,000 people at Thompson Bowling Arena and lost a game for the first time ever to Arkansas in Knoxville in overtime, 72-71. And, Pat, I was thinking on how to open the show, but I guess the only way I know to say it is the roller coaster ride with this basketball team continues.
Absolutely. A very, very disappointing loss for us. And, you know, I just think that we have got to find a way to regroup, and, you know, we've got games to play. But very disappointing for our team, and I'm certainly know that the fans were disappointed as well.
Pat, it seems like the basketball gods have tried every way in the world to let this team win the SEC regular season championship, but the loss to Arkansas pretty much seals the deal that there'll be a second seed in the SEC tournament next week. That's got to be disappointing as a coach.
Well, it's very disappointing for our whole coaching staff, and I'm sure our fans were disappointed as well. And you know, we just have to have the focus and know that we've got games to play, and that's what we got to look forward to. But we got to get better day to day in what we are doing, and you know, how much we are practicing, and you know, making them take some accountability, and that's exactly what we're going to talk about today.
When the Lady Vols headed to Mississippi to take on Mississippi State and Ole Miss in back-to-back games on the road, it was coming off the heels of an impressive performance and a win over Kentucky. And, Pat, going to the state of Mississippi, you had to feel pretty confident about this basketball team, but they didn't play the same way they did against Kentucky, did they?
Absolutely not. I mean, we were very disappointed. And, you know, it's a situation where, as I say many times, this team will wait and see, and we can't wait and see. We've got to be, you know, committed to what we have to do, and everyone on this basketball team has to understand that.
As we move to the highlights of the Tennessee win over Ole Miss, Pat, this team has shown a tendency not to shoot the ball well on the road, and it was the same way in this two-game stretch in Mississippi, wasn't it?
You know, there's no place like home, but in this situation, we did not step up and play as well as we needed to play.
The starters didn't shoot the ball well, but they came up with some defensive steals. Here's a breakaway layup by Megan Simmons, but that was all set up on the defensive end.
Exactly.
Lori Johnson with that fallaway shot, she must have worked on that a lot over the summer because she's really perfected.
She has, it's made a difference in her game.
Latasha Laws hit a three for Ole Miss. It was just 12-11 with about 8.5 minutes into the game. Shakina Strickland hits a three to make it a two-point Tennessee lead. And then Vicky Ball came off the bench and did some good things. Strickland there with a putback. But if it hadn't have been for Vicky Ball and Sierra Burdick in the first half, you'd have probably gone in the locker room behind.
Exactly. And both of them just really stepped up for us.
Valencia McFarland gave Tennessee a fit as a freshman down there. And the same way, she's a pretty good player as a sophomore.
She really is. I like her game, but I didn't like her playing against us, that's for sure.
Here's Sierra Burdick with one of her jump shots. You get her 15 feet in, she's deadly, isn't she, Pat?
Yes, and you know, she gets in the gym, and I think that's made a difference for her. Just passionate about getting in the gym and working on her skills.
In about 3 minutes, she hit three straight two-point shots, and Tennessee went into the locker room with a lead of 32-21. Not the best performance, but some good things happened in that half, and you just had to get them to replicate those things in the second half.
Exactly.
It starts out in the second half. McFarland had a drive for two that cut Tennessee's lead to six, and then Simmons with a driving layup. I don't know that I've seen a player that can shoot on the left side of the basket with a right hand as well as Megan Simmons can.
She can, and that's another player that really gets in the gym and works on her skills, and you can just tell that she's getting better and better.
Pat, Tabor Spaney, she's beginning to get back into things, but she's really not healthy on that leg yet, is she?
Not 100%, but, you know, she still can knock down the three ball, and we rely on her for that. But I think when she's completely healthy, there's a different Tabor Spaney.
In about a 30-second span, Glory Johnson hit three straight buckets inside the paint. And that third one gave Tennessee a 48-37 lead about the halfway point in the second half. And that was a big boost for this Tennessee team getting it inside to Glory.
It was huge. And Glory really worked the paint. And I just think that she understands. She's not trying to step out away from the basket. She just goes to work on the inside.
And you see the lead out, the run out pass to Megan Simmons. When this team gets to running, they're hard to defend.
Exactly. And, you know, Megan, she can just really run the floor very well. As well as Glory Johnson.
And then you see a closing layup by Glory Johnson, the assist to Vicky Ball, and Tennessee goes on to win by the final of 66-56. And Pat, on the road, you have to find ways to win sometimes when you're at your best, and that was the MO kind of the Ole Miss game, wasn't it?
Absolutely. But you know what? You just take it and you move on, and that's exactly what we have to do.
The Tennessee Lady Vols hosted the Razorbacks of Arkansas on Thursday night. It was the second meeting between these two teams this season. As we move to the headlights, I'll ask Pat Summitt. In the Arkansas game in Fayetteville, you were up 38-11 at the half. You ended up winning by 31. Did that kind of set this game up as a game where they might struggle a little bit?
Well, you know, I didn't think about that going in. I thought we were going to be ready. But this Arkansas team just came at us hard, right there running the floor. They were more aggressive than we were, which was disappointing to us. And you know, we just we can't do that anymore. I mean, we've got to constantly, you know, get in the paint and take care of the defense and the boards.
You know, Pat, the last Tennessee lead in the first half was 7-5.
Right.
And in the first half, on your own court, you were caught playing catch-up to Arkansas. And that had to be a concern because the starters didn't get off to a good start again.
Definitely. We didn't get off to a good start. And when you do that, sometimes, you know, you get in the panic mode. But you got to keep working, and you got to get the defense and the boards where they need to be and go inside right there.
And at this particular time in the game with Harrison, there was 3 minutes left in the game. You had no starters until Simmons came back in the lineup after that. You had no starters in the lineup for a little period of time.
Right. And obviously Megan came in and you know, did a good job for us. But, you know, across the board, we got to share the ball. We got to go inside.
At halftime, Tennessee trailed Arkansas 30-26. And then kind of got started as Strickland and Johnson started getting on a roll in the second half, and you can just see this team, when those two players are playing well, Pat, this team plays better.
Absolutely. They respond to those players, and that really gives them a lot of energy. And, you know, we just I thought we did a good job of getting the ball inside as well. Right there you see Glory Johnson. You know, I like it when she can get the paint points.
Shakina Strickland's going to hit a three here, and that was a big three because it cut Arkansas's lead to 2 at 41-39. Still plenty of time, 14 minutes to go.
Exactly. And, you know, Strickland can make those long-range shots, and then I think we got to do a better job of, you know, getting in the paint as well.
Strickland hit another three, and then Massengale ties the game with a layup at 44-44 with 12:02 to go. This is where Tennessee goes on a run.
Exactly. I thought things were going in our favor at that particular time.
You led 48-44, and then that lead was cut at 52-50 on a Massengale layup. You see the putback by Glory Johnson. That made it 55-50 Tennessee, and I think a lot of Tennessee fans felt pretty good at that time.
Well, and we had reason to feel good about it, but there's more basketball left to play.
Watkins got behind the defense and tied it up 62-62, and that's the way regulation ended. And then we go into a five-minute overtime. Strickland hits a three on the left wing, so you get up in overtime 70-67. Then back inside to Johnson. She couldn't finish, but Strickland with a putback. That made it 70-69 with 40 seconds to go. Then it came time to make free throws. Shakina Strickland missed 4 free throws in the overtime period alone. And you go and lose by 1 to Arkansas. And that's got to be a tough loss, not just for the coaching staff, but for the team as well.
Absolutely. I mean, free throws are what they are, and we've got to knock them down, and we didn't. And like I said, it just cost us the game. But you have to look and say, well, you know, there were other situations where we were not as solid or as good or didn't have ball security. But, you know, this one was a tough one to lose.
It's time now for Ask the Coach, presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors, now open in West Knoxville.
And Pat, Emma Maples wants to know on Senior Day Sunday, what's it going to be like saying goodbye to a big portion of this basketball team?
Well, first of all, we have to understand that these seniors have done a great job for us. And obviously, on Senior Day, it's always a special day. And I know we're going to miss this group. There's no doubt. They have really they've really invested with this team. And, you know, we do nothing but wish them well. And, you know, it's going to be hard to say goodbye to this group.
Senior Day is Sunday when Florida comes to Thompson Bowling Arena for a 3:30 tip. And then next week it'll be the SEC Tournament in the Bridgestone Arena in Nashville. And, Pat, this could be the best SEC tournament in a long time for women's basketball, but maybe the toughest one to win.
Absolutely. I think, you know, everyone is so much improved. And we just have to understand that we've got to have the focus that we need for every possession and everything we're doing, and we've got to communicate. And obviously, again, I go back to defense and boards. I mean, it's like a broken record, but that's what we have to do. We have to dominate the glass.
All right. So the SEC tournament coming up next week. While we have a quick second, happy birthday to Courtney Lyle, our director, and we'll see y'all next week on the Pat Summit Show.
This has been a presentation of the Vol Network, produced by IMG, the world's premier sports media and entertainment company. Produced at the Husker Broadcast Center.